Yeah, so going forward, I can't say that I'm always going to do leagues or anything like that, but I'm certainly willing to give it a try if that's what people want. And I don't mind just jamming some matches because I have not played this deck in a while. We're keeping this hand on the draw. The hand's fine. I'll keep pretty much any hand that has a Faithless Looting and a red source, to be honest. Looks like we're facing kind of a tricky matchup. This is one of our worst matchups, actually. We might be able to do something here because we have a Faithless Looting that can dig and a Tormenting Voice that can dig pretty deep into the deck. Blood Moon is not a dead card against them. They have Mox Opal to get around it, but it's pretty solid. And then we also have a shuffle effect to help break up a soft lock. But that said, Ensnaring Bridge is a heck of a card for us to try and beat. So we got our Miser Inquisition. We're going to fire it off. And we see an Aether Grid, a Lantern of Insight, and an Ensnaring Bridge. So I'm not afraid of Aether Grid. Without a lot of lock pieces in play, I think it's just going to be too slow to beat us. I'm going to take this Lantern of Insight. It seems like a pretty good one to get off the board. I think he maybe even should have led with that over the whatever the heck that card is. And then this next turn, we're going to Thoughtseize again and take out his Ensnaring Bridge. Or I shouldn't say Thoughtseize again. We Inquisitioned last time, but you get the idea. Okay, that's a good sign. That's a good sign. So we have to Thoughtseize this turn. The question is whether we Faithless Looting or not. And there's good reasons to Faithless Looting, there's good reasons not to Faithless Looting. The best reason to looting now is to make sure that we hit our land drop, but that only really helps us if we find another discard outlet, like a Thoughtseize, or another Faithless Looting, or even a Simian Spirit Guide to combine with this Tormenting Voice, because that would give us enough mana to Goryo's Vengeance back Emrakul next turn. The good reason to hold off on Faithless Looting is if we just draw that land naturally, then we just already have our discard outlet. So I think I'm going to wait a turn. Even if I brick, actually, even if I brick on the mana, not the mana, well, could be mana with Simian Spirit Guide, but even if we brick on the combo next turn, setting up the third land drop lets us Blood Moon. And I think that's pretty good against his current draw. So I'm going to fetch just so that I can use, well, I guess we should start with this looting, right? Because we could draw Simian Spirit Guide off the looting right now, and that would let us just Goryo's for the win, probably. But since we're going to looting, we might as well lead with it. Okay, cool. So we did, in fact, hit Simian Spirit Guide. We're going to discard Emrakul and I think Tormenting Voice. Yeah, I still like this. I guess we could discard the Temple of Malice because we're probably going to hit a land drop soonish. Yeah, I actually like that a little bit better. We're going to discard Temple of Malice and Emrakul. Then with the Emrakul trigger on the stack, pitch, cast. The Emrakul trigger still resolves, still shuffles our graveyard into our library, but not a big deal at this point. It can be an issue if you have a Griselbrand in your graveyard that you're trying to save for a rainy day, but in this case, we don't care. Roll one Emrakul down. Yeah, I think that was solid. Blackleave and Thoughtseizes me. Probably takes my Thoughtseize. Yep, because he wants to protect the Ensnaring Bridge that's in his hand. Okay. So right now I have the decision of playing this Tormenting Voice and discarding the Temple of Malice or the Blood Moon We're just leading with Temple of Malice for the Scry. I think I'm going to do that. I think I'm going to hold on to this Tormenting Voice for a turn. Pass the turn back to him. Okay. And he didn't have a, I suppose it would be his fourth land at this point. So I'm going to throw out Blood Moon. That actually protects us from a lot. He can't use discard now to pick apart our hand at all. He is only one mana away from casting that Ensnaring Bridge, though, so that could be a real issue. So the Blood Crypt is a red source. We're going to discard the Griselbrand, because that's our... Oh, dear. Okay. Oh, there's bridge territory. Looks like we're actually going to lose this game, but very slowly. Well, that Thoughtseize would have been good a while ago. Oh, that's his Thoughtseize. And if I was him, I would have been very hesitant to let me draw Simeon Spirit Guide. Because we have the Blood Moon in play, he shuffled his own library there with Lantern of Insight because he didn't want to draw Thoughtseize. That's a card that he can't actually get out of his own hand. Aether Grid, okay. So when cards are strapped in his hand, thanks to the Blood Moon, he has a Surgical, but he has to pay life for it. So he's Surgicaling Thoughtseize. He's getting a card that he can't actually cast out of his deck, but there still are other cards in his deck that he can't cast. Cards like Abrupt Decay, for example, could do the trick. I'm just going to flashback Faithless Looting. The second Blood Moon doesn't really do anything for us. Okay, we found another Simeon Spirit Guide. I guess we'll play it. Yeah, so the Surgical was good, just stripping a lot of cards that he can't play. We're going to hold on to the Faithless Looting until we have something to do with it. Got to come up with a point of damage. The Lantern's very good for him. Gives him a little bit of control over his own draws. I don't even really know what we're digging for. I think the game kind of depends on his draws more so than my own. That Tormenting Voice just didn't change at all because the top card of my library is revealed. Just didn't change. Okay, he pinged me there. He gets one more artifact in play. He can actually start pinging off my Simeon Spirit Guides. And I think he wins at that point. Damnation, not quite what I was looking for. But then I'm not really sure what we're looking for, so... Yeah, I think he actually wins the game here. Yep, because that's going to let him ping off a Simeon Spirit Guide, and he's going to be able to untap and ping off another Simeon Spirit Guide. I believe we are drawing dead after that. Yep. Got me. Wham, bam, thank you, ma'am. So, as you can see from that game one, we're very fast, we're very explosive, and we're very good at shredding what the opponent has going on in play. The problem with that game was that he did get to resolve his ensnaring bridge. Part of that is because he ripped a discard spell to get the Thoughtseize out of my hand and protect his own. Part of that was we didn't like quite lock up enough cards in his hand with the Blood Moon. He was able to shuffle away the Thoughtseize that he was going to draw. He was able to like surgically extract Thoughtseize so that he didn't draw more dead cards. The Blood Moon soft lock didn't quite get me there. Blood Moon is okay in the matchup, I think, but I don't know how excited about it I am. So we're going to bring in Ley Lines. Ley Lines are great in this matchup. He's got targeted discard, and he also has some lock pieces that are good to get rid of. Liliana of the Veil is a way we could potentially get rid of Ensnaring Bridge. I don't hate it. I also don't hate all this discard. Like, discard, stripping his discard and then letting us force through creatures and stuff that way. So it's important to think about, what do I not like? What is not very good in this matchup? And the fast mana isn't as necessary as usual. We're going to be like shredding each other's hands, so the fast mana isn't that good. Quicksilver Amulet is a little bit clunky. We can shave it through the breach. And then, and so that's room for three. That's assuming we want Inquisitions and we don't want Liliana. I kind of want Liliana in this matchup just because a Liliana ultimate is kind of difficult for him to deal with, although the uptick isn't very good in general. Let's see. So our Blood Moon's good. No, they're not that good. Liliana's good. They're like okay. Yeah, I'm gonna run this. The discard becomes dead so fast though. Yeah, maybe I'll just run like an even split. We'll try Liliana's instead of a couple Inquisitions. Because I think Liliana's fine. Like, if you ultimate a Liliana and make him choose all of his lands or his Ensnaring Bridges, if he keeps the Ensnaring Bridges so that he doesn't die, then he draws cards that he can't play because he doesn't have his lands anymore. And then we can start attacking again, maybe. Yeah, this hand is very, very bad. This is a hand that you might like mistakenly keep when you're first playing the deck because you're trying to figure out like what hands are good and what hands are bad. This hand does nothing. There's a lot of cards that turn the hand on, but they're not quite good enough. And the hand is still like not very good against discard too. Like if he Thoughtseize his main, takes the Emrakul. Like what am I doing? I'm probably not doing anything even with the Emrakul. So. And is a mull. The other nice thing about mulliganing aggressively post-board is that it gives us a free roll towards finding white ley line. I think we actually keep this. Gonna bottom that. He's gonna open with white ley line. And we're gonna cry a bit. That is, that's just our plan at this point. I don't even know if I like playing this Faithless Looting. I think I do because I have a dead card in Inquisition. I think I'm going to do something like that. But I just lose to a discard spell, so. Our best draw here is a Simeon Spirit Guide. That would let us Goryo's Vengeance him. Needle, probably going to name Griselbrand with that needle. Not the end of the world because we don't have a Griselbrand draw. He decides to name Liliana of the Veil. That's interesting. That is really interesting. Okay, and there's the Inquisition. That's probably going to take the Goryo's Vengeance out of my hand, I would imagine. Yeah, that's what it does. Welding Jar doesn't do too much. I'm not going to play this Looting, not quite yet. Just going to pass it back to him, see what he has to say. And this looks like an Ensnaring Bridge, yep. And I believe that locks me out, yep. So kind of a rough matchup in general. We did have two reasonable draws for the matchup. They just didn't match up well against what the opponent was doing. He had like the one draw in game one to get a discard spell to stop him from like losing the game to protect his Ensnaring Bridge. And then here in game two, we had a turn three Emrakul, but he not only had the ley line to protect his hand, but he had the piece of discard to shred our hand, and then the turn two Ensnaring Bridge as well, which is pretty good against us. Just how things match up. All right, under round two.